How is your blood going through her veins? I reckon it'll be thin as it's ever been, belting through a million miles an hour with five runners in the slipper.
It's very heady experience. I always say a prayer, and I just hope that my horse can win it. I know that we've put the work in, I know that I've got the horse good enough for the day, and then I just hope that Lady Luck comes our way.
Thinking if you have you done enough with your horse, haven't done too much. I've done my job, and see, that's up to the jockey then. So once they go, we pass them over, it's up to the jockeys.
Yeah, you've got to just remain cool, calm and collected, and naturally you're looking at the other horses. You've watched them all the way through their prep, and you're seeing if they're stirred up today and if there's any chinks in their armour, and you just try and sort of sort it all out before you get to the gates and keep your horse in the right frame of mind.
From a trainer's point of view, you've got to be a little bit calm, because not only have you got to keep your mind focused on your horses, you've got to keep the owners from going over the top, because they get so excited, they're so looking forward to the big day.
I mean, I try to keep pretty free of all sort of distractions and that, and just sort of get out there and focus on the one race. And it's just, at the end of the day, you've just got to treat it like another race, because it's a golden slipper and because it's the biggest two-year-old race. You sort of, I've never really let that interfere with the fact that it's just another two-year-old race at 1,200 metres and the best horse wins.
Burst has swapped Clan O'Sullivan.
There's a lot of things I do is not good for my health, so if it's getting a bit excited for winning a slipper, I'll put up with it.
Yes, it could be Clary Connors in just a short while doing the same thing. The punters don't seem to think so, though, in the betting ring. Really, the big story has been Chasseur for trainer Paul Perry. I spoke to Colin Tidy, who we heard from at the top of the show. He said the money started coming 20 minutes ago and just kept on coming. The big money, Chasseur, that is the big story. It is now the outright favourite for the 2002 Amy Golden Slipper, ahead of Bel Esprit. Some of the drifters have been Victory Vane. Quite surprising chuckle for Gay Waterhouse has been a drifter in the ring. It's terrible value on the tote compared to what you can get along the rails here. And Fortune for Clary Connors has been a drifter also in the ring. But boys, all the story here is with Chasseur.
Yes, well, New Castrians, is that what we call them, is
Nova Castrians.
Nova Castrians, they've made the trip up the highway, down the highway to Rose Hill Gardens, as have many other people who are here in expectation of what is going to be a wonderful race. Well, the two-year-olds have headed around to the 1,200-metre chute. They're around basically milling behind the barriers as we speak. Simon Marshall's over there with them. Been plenty of talk about Bel Esprit and his manners, particularly leading into going into the gates. Did he look calm, Simon?
I've just followed him up to the barriers here, Simon, and I'm talking quiet because this horse has not turned a hair. Now, he's about 5-6 metres from the barriers. He's walking past them now, and he could not give a continental, this horse. Completely different horse to what we saw at the Blue Diamond. He is so relaxed and happy. He's prelim, he's hardly turned a hair on the way around the barriers. So, Bel Esprit fans, keep putting it on. Looks fantastic.
Simon, Chasseur played up badly behind the barriers last week.
Yeah, he's a little bit on edge, Ken. He's getting led around by a barrier attendant. But, look, a lot of the two-year-olds will do that behind the gates. That's just the norm. He's not really jumping up and down in the air. His ears are forward. He just looks like he's ready to go, mate. He's switched on. He's just got that nervous energy about him. All he wants to do is get it on. But he's got his ears forward now, so he's not upset. He's fine, Ken. I thought that Snowland looked a treat. Also came around. Victory Vane took the eye. Planchette also not a problem there. Geez, these babies are really relaxed, actually. It's a big day. Huge crowd here out at Rose Hill. And credit to them all. They're all nice and relaxed. We've got no upsets at this particular point of time. Brief Embrace, also number 10. She got a lead around. Jimmy wanted to just bring her around nice and quiet. She's just coming up to the barriers now. She looks a treat. She looked just as good as she did Blue Diamond Day in the mounting yard. The lollies, not a problem. Number 12, Chuckles, is right here beside me. She's hardly turned a hair. She's just sweated up just nicely on the back, as you'd expect her to do with her prelim around the barriers. She's got a couple of taped up legs there. That's two hind quarters and her off front. Obviously, she speedy cuts a little bit, but she looks fantastic. Chuckles, not a problem. So at this point of time, guys, everything's A-OK.
All right, well, there's only 3 minutes to go, and on the tote, it is still $4.90 Bel Esprit, $5.40 second favourite Chasseur, likely to, that's him in centre screen now. Number two in the blue and brown colours, likely to earn a touch more.
I'll tell you what, we've been doing this Golden Slipper for a lot of years now from Rose Hill. I've never seen two-year-olds as relaxed You know, it's such a big day. People, hype, music, they've had everything to put them off in the pre-lead-up. And fair dinkum, you'd think they were six-year-old geldings.
I thought we'd be looking for 15 sets of earmuffs there for a while, but no, they've behaved beautifully. You couldn't put a knock on any runner in this field the way they've behaved themselves. And the interesting factor here, the two favourites will go in first, Ken. They'll barrier one.
And barrier eight. They go in, one and eight go together, two and nine, three and ten, like that. So they'll be the first two in the barriers, Bellesprit and Chazur.
Okay, Waterhouse, she's been here and done that before. She looks quite calm. So did John Simons, the pitcher you saw just prior to Gay Waterhouse. He seems to be quite in control of his emotions. And as he has said, there's not much he can do now. It's really the horse and Smokey that are out there on the field of battle.
Yeah, that's exactly right. I used to always marvel at how relaxed Tommy Smith was before a race. He'd laugh, but at about the half furlong, he'd get up and yell as loud as a five-bob punter, wouldn't he, Ron?
Yeah, for sure. I think they'll be putting this head collar, this stallion chain, on Bellesprit now, which is interesting. No other horse will go into the barrier until he goes in. Apparently, in the practice runs, he went in like a lamb. So we're about to find out.
Let's go to Simon Marshall and see what he says.
Now, this is amazing. They went to go and put this head collar on and this chain on this horse. He's going to walk straight into the barriers, guys, and not a problem whatsoever. Now, it was quite ironic. They were about three or four strides from putting this apparatus on him. He stood there, he looked at the bloke walking over with it, and he did not move. Waited for the apparatus to be put on his head, which is a head collar and a chain over the nose. He's walked straight in, and he's standing there getting a pat by one of the barrier attendants. So not a problem. Chouard Sir just walking in now. He's walked in beautiful. He's got an attendant up with him. He's copping a pat. Chuckle's just about to go in now. Everything say okay.
Righto, Simon. Yeah, Chuckle just went in. Notice the lollies has gone in. Jockeys will be a bit nervous at this point, Ronnie.
Yeah, they will be. This is where their thinking's all focused here, and knowing their colours, know what horses they're going to follow. There's a few no-hopers in this, and they'll be avoiding these horses if they're up early and on the speed.
Yeah, you don't want them getting in your way. They can cost you a half a length and at a vital stage. Danny Beasley just jumping off Victory Vane there as she's led forward without him. And TOB number seven, she goes in. And she won't give any trouble, and Dan will remount her when they get in the barrier. That's just normal with her, that she goes in without the jockey. Just a little bit nervous.
Yeah, she's a filly. She's ready to go. And the more I look at this top weight, the more impressed I was with him, this Bellesprit.
Well, at the Blue Diamond, Ron, you saw it. We watched it on television. He played up for 5 minutes.
Well, John Simons on one interview, I heard, he said he's improved three or four lengths. Well, I tell you, everything he's done here today is a different horse to we
saw. It's an indication he has improved. You know, if I could go run out the betting ring now, I'd be having something on him, saving on him.
We'll go quickly. All right, in they go. TAB number 14 has just taken its place. Whiskey on Ice. We'll give Terry Bailey plenty of chance here, because this is the big one. He's called brilliantly all day, and it'll be no different here. Terry Bailey of Sky Channel.
Thank you very much, Kenny. And Bellesprit moving in safely in a terrific betting race. Choisir has been heavily backed, as Andrew mentioned. There's been late money for Bellesprit, and Victory Vane's come in a point late in betting, and Chuckle's come in 2 points. Now, Snowland about to move in. Here's Callaway Gal coming up. Italian Adventure about to move in. Snowland was up to the gate, but he's backed away again. Yell about to move in before too long. One of the bolters to make up the complement of runners, the complement of 15. For the running of the greatest two-year-old race on the planet, the Amy Golden Slipper. Before too long, about to move in. Starter Billy Dale officially to let them go 25 years as the starter for the Amy Golden Slipper, and they're all set. Lights are on. Starter had a clear line. Bellesprit, gate number one. Ooh, DeLollies is reared up in two. Rider out the back, Starthy Katsidis. He balances up, tries to remount. Bellesprit, meantime, is not too bothered by it all. Chuckle has been well supported with Victory Vane late. Starthy Katsidis, who rode Callaway Gal with great success, back in the saddle. Starter waving his arms about. Are we ready? We're very close. DeLollies is rider back in the saddle. Before too long, Whiskey on Ice standing up well. Here we go. Set for the slipper. Racing. Great line. Bellesprit came out fairly. Choisir dropped back to last. Fast away is Yell. He's come out of the gate like a rocket, showing speed before too long. Victory Vane for Toon. Bellesprit going forward. Snowland wide from Brief Embrace. A length and a half further back is Chuckle from Callaway Gal centre field. They were followed by Italian Adventure, Whiskey on Ice, and then came Ponche, Dama de Noche. Well back is Choisir. He's on the outside back, second last. And the trailer is DeLollies. The leader is before too long. The bolter in front. Victory
Victory Vane at the 600, sped up to be second. Snowland three wide, cuts the breeze third. Yellow's on the fence, getting a nice run from Brief Embrace Platoon. They were being followed by Bella Spree, and he's hard at him on the fence from Callaway Gal. Well back is Chuckle, and Schwazier's come to the extreme outside on straightening up, and Bella Spree is being hard ridden behind them, looking for a run down to the 300 before too long in front. Victory Vane claimed it. Snowland, Brief Embrace, yell back behind them from Callaway Gal. Bella Spree can't get out, and Petronche's down the outside. Victory Vane in front. Callaway Gal for Queensland. Callaway Gal, Planchet and Schwazier, but Callaway Gal, Scott the Slayer, grabbed them. I think got there. Callaway Gal has just won the golden slipper from Victory Vane in a photo. Then Planchet or Schwazier for third from Bella Spree before too long. Yell behind those. They were followed by Brief Embrace, Snowland, Dama de Noche for Toon, Whiskey on Ice, Chuckle, and Italian Adventure, and just going past the post to Lollies.
Scott Seymour, he's done it again. What a year he's had. Number 8, Callaway Gal, 15, 10 and 360. Number 7, Victory Vane. Paul Bede Murray, second with Universal Prince in the BMW. Second in the slipper to pay 260. Very, very close for third. Callaway Gal, just off the speed. Come through when it mattered most. Bruce Brown said in an interview we showed you earlier, I brought her to Sydney for one race. I'm not worried about the two losses. This is why she come here. And he was right. Now let's pick up the action. If you watch towards the outside with yellow colours just getting into the open, pushing inside of the horse with the blue cap, which is Chuckle, is Callaway Gal. Now she goes after the leaders. Victory Vane is in front. Snowland in the red and black can't do any better. Now here she comes, Callaway Gal. Scott just puts his head down, wide out, flashing home from absolute last is Chazur. What a run he turned in. Just didn't have the speed early, and he's charged down the outside. But the winner is number 8, Callaway Gal. Second is number 7, Victory Vane. And third is number 2, Chazur. Officially fourth was Planchet. There, close up, we see Victory Vane with Danny Beasley throwing everything at her. But then right on the line, Scott Seymour. What a performance. Timmy Sheridan is in the enclosure with Winning Connections.
Well, Bruce Brown, you came down, got beaten twice, and today you got it.
Yeah, we set up for this one race, you know. I just third run up, just had the right day. Everything right at the treat. Got back a little bit firm than I thought she was, but it's worked out the right way.
Good barrier too, I mean, and ridden well from there.
Yeah, fabulous, yeah. Yeah, through, the greatest throw I've ever had.
Biggest day in your life, mate.
Yeah. I won $1 million race at Clowner, but this is something special. It's a group one now. My first group one, so wrapped.
Congratulations.
Thanks,
Bruce.
Very much.
Go and enjoy it, mate.
Great.
Yeah, thank you very much, Tim. And if Connections of Bella Spree are watching, he finished officially fifth, and they get their $100,000 back for just $100,000 of fifth prize. That's Bella Spree tucked in behind them with the yellow and red quartered cap, the jockey's head bobbing up and down. But here it's Victory Vane in front, Callaway Gal getting to her, Planchet wide out in the cerise colours. Then outside of him, the chestnut is Chasseur, who absolutely flashed home, and he's paid $220 for the place. But look, Callaway Gal had the right barrier. She was produced on the day by Bruce Brown, son of a star trainer in Sid Brown, who trained such champions as Woodcourt Inn and Triton and Kister and even Red Craze at one stage. And I'm sure Sid will be a very proud man today to see his son Bruce Brown train the winner of the Golden Slipper. And the winning jockey, of course, Scott Seymour, and he's with Simon Marshall.
Well, Kenny, I don't know what to say to this bloke. We've had him up here three times already. He won the BMW earlier. That's not a bad little feat, $1 million race. He pops up and wins the Golden Slipper. Caulfield, Melbourne Cubs, Golden Slipper. Scotty, you're going to have to buy a new house for these trophies.
Yeah, might have to.
How about that, mate? Little Galloway girl. She's not big, folks, this filly, but plenty of heart. How was the run?
Yeah, she had a lot of luck. She was midfield on the fence. Got off the fence at the 600, then come out into the straight. She never had a trouble in the world, you know. She always said she was one of the two-year-olds that was on the way up.
Yep.
And she proved it today. She proved for three starts ago that Victory Vane beat her than last start. I knew she'd beat Victory Vane this start because she was on the way up.
Fantastic. Scotty, we've got Vossi. Straight to you, mate. Well done, Scotty Callaway.
Well, Simon, I'm with Bede Murray. What sort of day has Bede Murray had? Nutted in the BMW with Universal Prince second and now with Victory Vane. Well, I've got to ask the obvious question. Did you think you were home then?
Yeah, I thought so, but, you know, she got to the front a little bit early, perhaps, you know, but I suppose that's how we had to ride her. But, you know, they did say they do come from behind.
Bede, when you sit back later tonight, how do you think you'll look back on Golden Slipper Day 2002?
Oh, it was a great day, but it could have been a little bit better.
I think that's an understatement. Could have been a lot better. Plans for Victory Vane?
She'll probably run in the size, I think. See how she pulls up.
Well, it's 2 seconds for Bede Murray today. Well done, mate.
Thanks very much.
Yeah, Bede Murray trains at Conjola on the south coast. He's got a second stable at Kembla Grange, just about 100 kilometres south of Sydney. And there's Scott Seamer representing Queensland. Queensland's first win in the Slipper. Guineas did a lot of racing up there, but he was from the John Hawke stable in Sydney. And here, Callaway Gal, trained at Doomben by Bruce Brown, and represented the state of Queensland very proudly indeed. And, well, Bruce Brown should think a job extremely well done. As Connections lead her back in, she had 4 starts in Brisbane for 4 wins. She came to Sydney. First up, she finished 3rd behind Victory Vane in the Sweet Embrace, then 2nd behind Victory Vane in the Magic Knight. And then today, she beat Victory Vane in the 2nd in the race that counted. So her record is now 7 starts for 5 wins. And, well, she takes home the bulk of the prize money, first prize being $1.5 million. Well, it's a lot of prize money, Ronnie.
Oh, I couldn't be more impressed with this, the way that Bruce Brown's handled this filly. He said all along, don't worry, don't worry, don't worry. And she relaxed better today, and she turned the tables on Victory Vane.
Yeah, for such a young bloke to put his hand up and basically say, hey, here I am, he's done a great job under pressure.
Well, he said to the owners, you just pay up for this horse, she'll be running well.
Yes, they had to pay a $100,000 late entry fee, which they paid. They had to pay it for Victory Vane, which they paid. They both got their money back, as did Bella Spree, who finished 5th. For $100,000 prize money. Sid Brown, I'm sure he's at Rosehill today. If not, he'd be home at Warwick Farm, and he'd be that proud of his son. His 2 sons, Errol, a former jockey who also trains, and Bruce grew up with horses like Triton. Now he's got a champ of his own.
Well, he certainly has, and we're going to take a quick break from Rosehill Gardens. 2002 Golden Slipper Day, and lots more run racing to come during the autumn.
Next Saturday on Wide World of Sports, racing's emerging superstars collide in a classic derby confrontation. In the blue corner, it's Carnegie Express. He's won 6 on the trot, does everything right, and costs just $45,000.
But Carnegie Express, he's got a great turn of foot. He's holding Don Eduardo, and Carnegie Express wins the Rosehill Guineas. And
in the red corner, meet Don Eduardo. His potential is untapped. He's a jockey's nightmare, and his price tag was a record $2.8 million.
Don Eduardo, perhaps staying the better, grabs the lead, draws clear, and from last, it's Don Eduardo beating Leather Lane by a length and a nose.
Can Australasia's most expensive horse reign supreme on racing's richest day? Or will Carnegie Express join the elite who've won racing's triple crown? Don Eduardo versus Carnegie Express. Lee Friedman versus Gay Waterhouse. Damien Oliver versus Jim Cassidy. Whatever way you look at it, the AJC Derby has it all.
Gates explode back.
Then, when the 3-year-old scores are settled, the world's best mare again takes centre stage in the San Miguel Doncaster.
Sunline, the leader, she's pulling out everything. Sunline, the great mare, but Sunline, she does it again.
At age 6, can the mighty Sunline win a second Doncaster? There's $8 million up for grabs on Australian Racing's richest afternoon. It's San Miguel Doncaster Day, live from Randwick, next Saturday on Wide World of Sports.
Here they are, thundering to the line, Kenny, in the 2002 Amy Golden Slipper.
Yeah, had a little bit of trouble getting off the rails, the favourite, Bella Spree, but I don't think he'd have beat the winner, Simon.
No, I don't think he would have beaten the winner, but I don't think anyone can beat Scott Seamer, because Fair Dinkum, look, he would win on a old rust bucket at the moment. His timing, the way he's reading races, getting his horses into the clear to get a shot at the line with no interference is just amazing. You know, it's
to repeat again, that's the filly in the black and yellow, about centre screen now. jockey wielding the whip in his left hand. In the blue sleeves outside him is Chuckle. She's just dropping out of touch. It's Planche in the Cerise, and then widest of all, Chasseur. Chasseur was definitely a little bit further back than we expected, but he's been beaten less than a length, and he had a quiet run to the turn. But when you consider the time they ran, it's no surprise that he didn't run down the horses on the speed, because the official time was 1:08.81, which is a Golden Slipper record, breaks by 7/100ths Bintmarsh's Golden Slipper record, and as fast a time than is run by all those champions like Luskin, Star and Vane. Callaway Gal, $15.10 and $3.60. Victory Vane, $2.60. Chasseur, $2.20. In Victoria, she paid exactly the same, and on Unitab in Queensland and South Australia, as to be expected with all that Queensland money on her, Callaway Gal only paid $9.50.
Andrew Voss has already had a yarn to beat Murray. I mean, you've got a feel for him, don't you? He's come here with two genuine Group 1 chances. They've both run second, beaten a nostril both. I mean, it's a gut-wrenching game, this sometimes. It can rip you apart.
He won the Derby last year, Bede. He's had a terrific season. He's a good horse trainer. He'll have a few beers tonight and get over it, but you've got a feel for him. Simon, you're a breeding buff. What was the winner by?
It was by Klang. Ken, now, have you got anything to tell me about Klang?
Klang was one of the Jack and Bob Ingham string. It was by Bellotto and was just a second-tier horse, and I think they're a bit rattle-headed, a few of them, but that one's not.
Oh, certainly. She certainly isn't, and she'll deserve that rug hanging around her body for a long, long time. So were the people getting the trophies to the Connections now, and Andrew Voss at the presentation.
Ladies and gentlemen and viewers through the wide world of sports, it's fair dinkum like a State of Origin match down here. They're all chanting Queenslander, and why not? What a win to the 2002 Amy Golden Slipper. And to kick off the presentation, I'd like to call on the chairman of the Sydney Turf Club, Mr. Bruce McHugh.
What a day. Before I introduce Mr. Brian Keane, the Chief Executive Officer from Amy, to make the presentations, there are a few things I would like to say about Amy. First of all, it's a leading Australian brand name focusing on and specialising in car and home insurance. I believe they're probably the most trusted and respected company in the insurance field. Amy is innovative in the insurance world and also the business world. One of their examples being their customer charter, where if they breach their own charter, they fine themselves and pay the penalty to their customer. Their claim service is second to none, and for those that haven't experienced making a claim with Amy, I know we don't want to, but I can assure you their claims results are outstanding in the way they treat their customers. I'd also like to say that when you phone them, you get an expert and a very professional person answering the phone, and that I find, in this day and age, something special. And lastly, who can forget their witty, humorous and charming ads? Don't we all love the jingle, which I'd love to sing, but I better not, "Lucky You're With Amy." Without further ado, I'd like to introduce Brian Keane to make the presentations to the winner, but before I do, firstly, this race was won in 57 by a horse called Todman, which I'm sure we all are aware of. Let me say that Todman was probably the best horse, maybe have been the best horse to win the race. Today, that high standard has been carried right through. And today, when Callaway Gal won it, I'm sure when she broke the record, she's continuing to on that fine trend. And from now on, you'll probably find the slipper will go in that same direction. Today's field was outstanding, and as a result, we've got a beautiful winner in Callaway Gal. I'd now ask Brian Keane to make the presentation to the winning Connections.
Thanks, Bruce. Thank you, Bruce. Mr. Chairman, the committee, at Amy, we're honoured to be associated with the STC in this most exciting of races. I want to congratulate you, Mr. McHugh, and your committee and your staff on the way it's been presented, and also to acknowledge the support and involvement of the Daily Telegraph in the way it's been promoted. And when you see the excitement and quality and enthusiasm that's here today, there's nothing to prevent us harnessing all that obvious goodwill from all sections of the racing community to assure the growth and success of racing in New South Wales long into the future. And the Golden Slipper is undoubtedly part of that future. It's the best race for two-year-olds in the world, and it's been won by the who's who of racing.
It's competition at the highest level. Simply to be good enough to qualify is an achievement in itself. It's the championship. And there can be only one winner. And today, the Golden Slipper belongs to a Queenslander, Callaway Girl. And on behalf of Amy, it gives me great pleasure to congratulate the owners, Bob, Pat Brennan, Annette and Merv Caldwell, and Bob Hamilton, and to ask Bob Brennan to accept the trophy for the Golden Slipper. Bob. No, we'll do that later.
Chairman and committee of the STC, Chief Executive of AAMI, what can I say? We're a bit excited down here from Queensland. Hey, a few Queenslanders out there, I can see that. A little filly, this is racing all about. This is what it's all about. Little filly bred up at Craigsley at the back of Kennelwork on the Sunshine Coast for very little cost. And she can come down today and win this magnificent race against some of the most finest two-year-olds that you could ever hope to have to race against. And I think that the horse is just magnificent. And I know that my joint owners, Merv and Annette Corwell, and Bob Hamilton, my wife Pat, are over the moon. We thought she had a good chance, and she certainly proved that she is very fast. And Scott Seamer said, last week, I'll turn it around next week, and he did. Great. The trainer, what can you say about Bruce? He brought that horse along right from the start, brought it down here, stayed at his father, Sid Brown, a trainer in his own right for many years. And the strapper, Willie, who never left the horse aside. His wife, Chris, a magnificent effort. I don't think he could ask for any more. He brought the horse right to its peak today, and when she dropped down 3 kilos, she was always going to be very hard to beat, and she was. She won it. And the Scott Seamer, what can you say? He just keeps riding Group 1 winners. Mind you, I know he lives at Ballinan, but we might call him a Queenslander as well. We might cheat a little bit, Scott. And so I think Queensland's done proud. This is great for Queensland racing. I'd like to thank everybody concerned on behalf of all the owners. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please congratulate and welcome Bruce Brown.
Chairman, members of the STC, sponsors are so vital in this sort of racing. We need those people. I'd like to thank the owners for giving me this horse to train. My staff, Willie down there looking after the horse. He, as I say, he's the only person who can ride her. My other staff back in Brisbane, they've done a great job. I've been away for this week. And also I'd like to thank my wife. She's been running the show while I was away. Her and the kids flew down this morning. And also like to Scotty for a great ride. I said, you just got to ride one more winner, Group 1 this year, and he's done it. I don't care if he doesn't ride another one for a while. That's up to him. Thank you.
And please welcome a great rider and a good bloke, Scotty Seamer.
Members of the committee, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me great pleasure to be here today. Since I've rode the filly, her last 3 starts, I said she was going to be primed for...